here today with the Mastodon jaw. This jaw is 4 foot, 4 inches long, so it's really large. With the skull, which we are prepping right now, once that is in place on top of the jaw, the entire head should be right about this tall. So it's a massive creature. And besides being really large, it already has a lot of stories to tell. Down here, in the M3, the back molar, we actually have a broken cusp. So he ate something or attempted to eat something that was hard enough to actually break the cusp off, and has since he's worn around it, so he was still chewing and was using this tooth. He actually had a break on the opposite side of the mouth on the upper tooth as well, so he's done this more than once. There's a foramen right here, in case you're wondering. This hole is where nerves and blood vessels exit through the jaw after feeding each tooth, and then feeds the lips or gums. If you've ever gone to the dentist and they inject you in the back of the mouth, that's why that side of your face goes numb. It feeds all the way through there. There's a slot here for the M1. This tooth was present on this side of the jaw, but had already been lost on this side of the jaw. So he's right up, sort of towards adult age, losing the M1, and the M3 is coming in behind. The tusks are sticking out probably about 9 inches, but they actually go all the way through the jaw to about here. So they're very deeply inserted into the jaw. He's been using them with a lot of leverage and a lot of force. You can actually see this beveling on the front. They've been used to strip bark or do something else that has actually left its mark on the tusks. We've turned the jaw around now on the cart. You're looking at the left side of the jaw, which required a lot more reconstruction. It was extensively damaged, smashed flat pretty much by a desk-size limestone boulder. So a lot of work went into getting this back together. We've used some new techniques to help us with the large reconstruction for these bigger bones. This is actually an aluminum sheath that is completely encased in glue and is also backed by our new spider webbing technique. So if you're curious about what that is, we actually have another video on our YouTube channel that shows the time lapse for this going together. A really nice technique for putting together these larger bones. Another thing that we did in reconstructing this is we wanted to leave the actual lower tusks out. There's a lot of information that researchers can get to on these things. Little growth lines along the entire length of the tusk. They do go back all the way to here, so that would have taken away a foot worth of research material, basically. And another issue was that the entire bone structure here you see, the front half of the jaw, without the tusks is hollow. So we wanted to leave them out for researchers, but we wanted this to be strong enough to hold itself together. The original tusks are also very heavy and very brittle, so they're not suitable for carrying that weight once the animal's dead anyway. So what we did was we actually took them out, scanned them, and then made exact copies with our 3D printer, and then they've been painted to match. And these strong prosthetic tusks have then been glued into the symphysis to provide the structural support I needed to make sure that the two halves of the jaw did not break apart like a wishbone. So the real tusks are in collections where researchers can look at them, and these exact replicas have been glued into place. And we have another fun video for you on the YouTube page for that. So this is an ongoing project. Please check back in regularly for updates, and thank you for watching.